Hi, this is Dr. Vijay. Today we are going to study LDL and VLDL metabolism. So this LDL and VLDL metabolism is a transport of lipids between liver and extrahepatic tissues. And this pathway is also known as endogenous pathway. Perhaps liver has the capacity to synthesize various lipids and they are packaged in the form of VLDL and later this VLDL converted to LDL and most of this LDL handover to extrahepatic tissues. Unlike carbohydrates and proteins, these lipids are not water soluble. They are water immiscible. So this problem is solved by mixing of these lipids with apoproteins. So the apolipoproteins or apoproteins act as a carrier molecule or vehicle for the transport of lipids between different organs. In this case, between liver and extrahepatic tissues. So here we have a liver. Our liver has got the capacity to synthesize fatty acids. So this pathway is called de novo biosynthesis of fatty acid. As the liver synthesizes fatty acid, three fatty acids combines with glycerol. So it could be released from the hydrolysis of triglycerides or it can be acquired from the circulatory hydrolysis of lipoproteins by lipoprotein lipase. Now, the three fatty acids combines with this glycerol to give triacylglycerol or triglyceride. So, in the liver, whatever fatty acids are synthesized, they are converted to triacylglycerol or triglycerides. Similarly, the two fatty acids combines with phosphoric acid and glycerol backbone and choline to give phospholipids. So within the liver, triglycerides and phospholipids are generated. And liver cells or hepatocytes has got the capacity to synthesize cholesterol. And also these cholesterol can be generated from the chylomicron remnants which are derived from the exogenous pathway. They can be hydrolyzed to give, the cholesterol esters can be hydrolyzed to give free cholesterol and fatty acid. Now this cholesterol or free cholesterol can combine with one fatty acid or esterified with one fatty acid to give cholesterol ester. So we have the different types of lipids within the liver. So and remember, majority of these lipids are endogenously synthesized or synthesized within the hepatocytes or within the liver. Besides these lipids, liver also has got the capacity to synthesize some of the apoproteins like apoprotein E, apoprotein C, and apoprotein B100. These apoproteins plays a major role in transport of lipids from the liver to the extrahepatic tissues through circulation. Now we have lipids and apoproteins within the liver and all these are packaged in the form of VLDL and released to the circulation. Now here I have liver and the extrahepatic tissue. The metabolism of VLDL and LDL between the liver and between the adipose tissue or extrahepatic tissues. Now the endogenously synthesized lipids are packaged and released to the circulation in the form of nascent VLDL. So this newly synthesized VLDL is called nascent VLDL and the major apolipoprotein is ApoB100. And also it contains a small amount of ApoC and ApoE. Once this nascent VLDL approaches circulation or present in the circulation, it acquires some of the ApoE and ApoC2 from the circulating HDL. And also we studied in HDL metabolism, this nascent VLDL acquires some more cholesterol esters from the HDL and it handovers some amount of its triglyceride to circulating HDL. This is mainly by a protein called cholesterol ester transfer protein. This we already studied in reverse cholesterol transport mechanism or HDL metabolism. Now after acquiring some more ApoC and E and more cholesterol esters, this nascent VLDL becomes mature VLDL. Now this ApoC2, which is present on the surface of this mature VLDL, activates the lipoprotein lipase enzyme which is present on the walls of capillaries or blood vessels. So once this lipoprotein lipase is activated, it acts on the triglycerides present on the central dense core of this mature VLDL. So it starts hydrolyzing fatty acids from the triglyceride one by one. In this way, it hydrolyzes lot of triglycerides and it handovers glycerol backbone to the liver through the circulation. So now more and more triglycerides are hydrolyzed, more and more fatty acids are deposited in the extrahepatic tissue through the circulation. So in this way, this mature VLDL becomes small because more and more triglycerides are hydrolyzed by lipoprotein lipase. So this mature VLDL becomes IDL or intermediary density lipoprotein. You can see the size of this mature VLDL and IDL. It is small because some amount of triglycerides are hydrolyzed by lipoprotein lipase. Now this intermediary density lipoprotein, further it moves in the circulation. Again in the walls of the capillaries, the lipoprotein lipase is activated by ApoC present in the intermediary density lipoprotein. And this activated lipoprotein lipase starts hydrolyzing more and more triglycerides present in the central dense core of this IDL. And this formation of IDL is transient in nature. It is very fast. This intermediary density lipoprotein further becomes small because major amount of triglycerides are hydrolyzed by lipoprotein lipase and glycerol will be handed over to the liver. So this IDL becomes smaller and it is rich with the cholesterol esters. Now this lipoprotein handovers its ApoE to circulating HDL and also ApoC2 to the circulating HDL. And this molecule is called LDL. Please appreciate the size of the mature VLDL, IDL and LDL. So LDL is the smaller when compared to VLDL and IDL. And the amount of triglycerides goes on decreasing from VLDL to IDL and from IDL to LDL. And this LDL is cholesterol ester rich lipoprotein and it has got only one apolipoprotein, that is ApoB100. Now what is the fate of this LDL? This LDL, the majority of this LDL taken to extrahepatic tissues through receptor-mediated endocytosis, there is a receptor on the surface of extrahepatic cells. This receptor is called LDL receptor. Remember, 70 to 75% of cholesterol ester-rich LDL taken to extrahepatic tissue through this LDL receptor. Remaining 25 to 30% of this LDL taken to liver through LDL receptor, that is receptor-mediated endocytosis. So, whatever endogenously derived lipids, they are packaged and released as nascent VLDL. Then, it acquires some amount of ApoE and ApoC2 from the HDL. And also, it acquires some more amount of cholesterol esters from the circulating HDL. And lipoprotein lipase hydrolyzes some amount of triglycerides. It will become IDL. Further hydrolysis of triglyceride by lipoprotein lipase and it will be converted to LDL after handovering its ApoE and ApoC2 to circulatory HDL. So this LDL, which is formed from the VLDL or IDL, taken to extrahepatic tissue through LDL receptors. A small amount, about 25 to 30% will be uptake by liver through again LDL receptor. This LDL receptor mainly recognized by ApoB100. So the ApoB100 acts as a ligand. So because IDL also contains ApoB100, even this IDL can be taken through this LDL receptor, but major portion is LDL. You need to remember the metabolism of VLDL or LDL is mainly the endogenous pathway or endogenously derived lipids. No doubt there are some of the lipids are derived from chylomicron remnants which are taken to the liver through LRP from the dietary lipids, but major bulk lipids are lipids synthesized within the liver and released into the circulation as VLDL. This is with respect to LDL metabolism or VLDL metabolism or intrinsic pathway or endogenous pathway. If you haven't subscribed, please subscribe this channel. Press the bell icon for future notification. Thanks for watching.